Hi, this is Josh with Retro TV One Tech, and today I'm taking you through the Blockbuster Experience. This is the ultimate Blockbuster Experience for anybody who remembers these amazing stores from my childhood, renting video games, renting movies, DVDs, whatever you can think of, all the candy, all the fun. It's all right here at the Blockbuster Experience. We're here at the Central Florida Fairgrounds to check this out, but this place is gonna be popping up all over Central Florida and probably all over the country. So stay tuned and we'll post more information about it in the description. But I hope you'll join us for this awesome tour of the Blockbuster Experience. Let's get started. So we first saw this and posted on the channel when they were at Fort Wilderness Resort and Campground at Disney, and now it's expanded and it's just bigger and better than ever. So we cannot wait to check this out. All right, guys, let's go in. It's open.
We got 4 new hires.
Oh wow, looks right off the bat with the classic movie posters here. Check this out. Oh my goodness. Wow. It's awesome. All right, so we are checked in for our shift here at Blockbuster. Liam's got his vest on. What do you think, bud? Did you ever think you'd work at a Blockbuster?
Big.
Yeah, it's big. Pretty awesome though, right?
Yeah.
You are ready to go. So here we are, and we're gonna take you on a huge tour of this place. There's so much original memorabilia here. It is amazing. So this is an original sign from a Blockbuster. So incredible. It's really larger than life. You can see, you know, next to this ATM, you can kind of see how tall it is, or how, you know, how long it is. It's really incredible. And you see all the old movie posters and stuff like that. So cool. And you can also buy movies here. $5 for any movie that you want, which is pretty incredible. Even all these classic Disney movies over here, you could literally buy any of these for $5. And look at the classic nature of this stuff too. I mean, you've got all these different things. You've got Lady and the Tramp 2. You've got an Air Bud, Lady and the Tramp 1. Thumbelina. That is so cool. Oh my goodness. And so this is officially affiliated with the Blockbuster in the Last Blockbuster in Bend, Oregon. So actually they are in partnership with them, which is really cool. So they're kind of officially part of that group. So it's pretty cool. Look at that.
That was a book.
Oh no, here, open it up. Yeah. That's the original inside of the of the awesome
look at that, man.
Disney videos. And they all had that same style in the case. That's very, very classic. Here's another Blockbuster sign, and you can see the Last Blockbuster Portland Retro Gaming Expo. That's pretty cool. Actually would like to get out to that sometime. Oh, and then you can get your picture over here, which is cool. Now this right here, she was just telling me, this is actually a counter from an original Blockbuster. It's actually was used in a real Blockbuster store, so you get the whole experience here with this, which is so cool. So this is actually a monitor from the original POS system in Blockbuster, and you can actually tell that it's burned in. They don't have it connected, it's not on or anything, it's actually just burned in to the point where the menu is just stuck on the screens. It's CRT, so CRTs do burn in, and that's the proof of that. This is also an original Dropbox here. You could just drop your movies right in there, which is so incredible. They've got shirts and things here, and I love the new releases and everything. Now available, all those things. I remember how exciting it would be when you walked in the store. It's like, oh, that movie's finally out, or that movie's finally out. You guys remember that? It was so cool. And of course, most Blockbusters would have a popcorn machine, which is awesome. And here's a security camera, and this one actually is not plugged in either. It's all completely burned in from the Blockbuster, so that's pretty cool. You can really see the screen there. You can even see, like, where the shelves would have been with all the movies and things on there. So that's pretty awesome. And even you've got a giant tape of Nightmare Before Christmas, which is categorized into horror. That's funny. You can see the little horror sticker on it. And what visit to Blockbuster would be complete without snacks? And of course, you know, very similar to the kind of snacks you'd actually see in the store. And it was always, you know, you get to the counter and they had all the snacks there. I was like, Mom, can I have a, Dad, can I have a, you know? So yeah, anyway, this is amazing. I'm gonna go ahead and take you on a tour of the rest of the store. Oh wow, look at this. Burt Reynolds, Cannonball Run. Look at that, it's like a tailgate from a truck. Old GMC, how cool is that? Wow, that is awesome. They already got, Mom and Dad already got some movies. I'm going through here and just find all kinds of things. I was saying I still have a VHS player. So I could actually grab something. So we'll see. I may. But did you find something? Lord of the Rings on VHS. That's cool. Probably on DVD. I don't know that we ever had a VHS, but hey, that's pretty cool that they have that. Yeah, so lots of amazing movies and things. Let me know if you see anything that brings back a good memory or anything, Little Man. That's cool. Remember a lot of those. Just really classic movies. Liam is picking out some movies. Here you can see the family section, and again, lots of amazing Disney movies with those classic cases, and even Babe over here. This is so incredible. Of course, not a Disney movie, but definitely still a similar case style. Princess Diaries. My goodness, Flubber. Wow. Free Willy, 1 and 2. Multiple copies, Land Before Time, Beethoven's 4th. Sound of Music. Oh, Escape to Witch Mountain. Oh my goodness, the nostalgia is real, guys. The nostalgia is real. And these are, a lot of these are real shelves from actual Blockbusters. So they've gone all over the country looking for some of this memorabilia and some of these shelves and things, and they buy shelves from actual Blockbusters. So that's what a lot of this stuff is, from actual stores now that used to operate. So even the you know, from the carpets, you can tell it's all well worn and well used, and that's the whole idea of the experience. And they don't know where they're going to be next, but they do have an Instagram, and I'll link all that in the description if you want to keep track of where they are and where they're going to be next. But they're going to go to, you know, conventions, retro cons, 90s cons, things like that, where you can enjoy this experience for yourself. It's really cool and very nostalgic. So, love it. I mean, literally, it's like a store, and it's about the same size. It's in this warehouse here. So it really is about the same size as a Blockbuster Video would have been back in the day. They said they've got over 15,000 movies, and again, all available for sale, which is cool. So there's no rental, there's no late fees now. It's just all available.
There it is.
We had Transformer movies. Oh my goodness, you found some stuff. That's cool, dude. You know what the cool thing about these are? There's no late fees. you just buy them.
Oh, yeah, I love it.
And by the way, I didn't introduce on this video, Mom, Dad, and Liam. This is my mom and dad, and Liam, my son.
Yay.
We got the whole family here hanging out at Blockbuster. Usually, the Resort TV One people know, but if anybody's just on Retro TV One Tech, might not know everybody. So there you go. But Blockbuster is a family experience. So.
Yeah, it is. What do you say, sweetie?
Oh, the old Robin Hood, yeah. And also,
what year was that?
Oh, that's old. That's like before Prince of Thieves.
Yeah.
The not the Kevin Costner one. That's
Whoa.
Crazy.
Does it have a year on the back?
I can check it.
Chipmunks.
Wow. Liam saw the chipmunks.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
It should have a year back here, please.
Garfield. So cool. Yeah, just seeing the shelves is very nostalgic. So they did say that the movies aren't really in order, except for there was the family section and things like that. Just, there's so many classic movies. You've got Pretty Woman there, that's a pretty iconic cover. Son-in-Law, that was pretty iconic with the American Gothic theme. And then there's Something About Mary. All those things, oh my goodness. Four Weddings, yep. Al Pacino there, Sense of a Woman, Philadelphia.
Mr. Baseball,
Tom Selleck. Yeah, I mean, literally, you could walk around here and think that you are in the 80s or 90s, except for the videos in 4K. There's Air Force One, Independence Day, Punky Brewster, Josie and the Pussycats. Oh my goodness, guys, the nostalgia is real. There's The Rock. We actually had that movie on VHS. And then Turtles. That's cool. That's a 2007 movie, so that's a little bit newer, but that's cool, buddy. That's awesome.
He's coming over.
There's Speed, Cocoon. Wow. As Good as It Gets. So many great movies. Sister Act, Mean Girls. And they even have Blu-rays. And Blockbuster, you know, did have Blu-rays, because Blu-rays were out, you know, before Blockbuster started to fade away. But so they do have the whole kind of Blu-ray section, and DVDs are kind of sprinkled throughout the area. So, and again, I keep coming back to the snacks. Now, some Blockbusters did actually sell videos and movies when they, you know, got to the point where they didn't need as many of them. They'd always buy a bunch of them so they could have, you know, whatever the latest release was for everybody to rent. And then they would sell kind of the extras, and they'd keep just a couple as the movies were less popular. Cool to see the Steven Seagal poster there. Again, all this classic stuff, because all the Blockbusters would have, you know, all, there's Thelma and Louise over there. They'd have all these advertisements for different movies that were current at the time. So that was the fun part, is, you know, just kind of getting excited about whatever was next and whatever was new. So, pretty cool. I love that. I didn't say this already, but I love the Major League thing over there. I remember that. I remember actually seeing that in the stores. So, all right, guys, we have Sandi from the Last Blockbuster featured in the Netflix documentary. She still works at the Last Blockbuster in Bend, Oregon. And how many years did you say?
This is my 20th year.
20th year. Now, how long has the store been in existence? When did it open?
The store actually opened in 1991 as Pacific Video.
Okay.
And then we became Blockbuster in 2000.
Okay.
So that store has been a Blockbuster for 24 years, and then I've been there for 20 of those 24 years.
Wow. How many, all the changes that you've seen, it's probably just pretty mind-boggling.
It is. So my introduction was during the end of late fees in 2004, which was the peak of Blockbuster when it had the most stores across the country and in the world, actually. So yeah, it's been a wild ride. It is definitely a fun adventure and a cool place to walk.
So have you, you know, kind of experienced this whole transition from Blockbuster being kind of the premier place to get a movie into now kind of a really cool retro thing to hang out and have good memories? Like, what's that transition been like?
You know, it's kind of been a whirlwind because, you know, at the beginning, it was great. It was exciting. We had so many stores. And then you go through the dip and all the stores closing and then Dish Network buying the company and closing all the corporate stores and not really sure how it was going to go. And, you know, we were really not sure if we were going to last past 2018.
Right.
And then Alaska closed their stores and we became the last one in America. And then the last one in Perth, Australia closed in 2019. We became last one in the world. And
right.
Everything just kind of... You just shot up. You know, we did a documentary, as you talked about. I've done so much media.
Right.
We've done TV shows. We've done so much fun and cool things. So it's definitely an amazing experience. And I get to go and do fun stuff like this.
Oh, yeah.
And travel around. This is the first time we've gone outside of Oregon. We have done a couple of retro game events where you'll see some signs around here from that.
Right.
In Portland, but we hadn't gone anywhere else. So this is exciting for us to kind of gauge people's excitement and see what people think and if it's something that we want to try to do across the country.
Oh yeah, when we saw this first setup last year at the Fort Wilderness, you know, it was much smaller, of course, but it was just so exciting. You know, even just seeing the marquee board over here, you know, and remembering what it was like to walk into that in the store.
And that was something that Julie did as just a special Halloween thing, as her little Halloween competition, created her own little one. So she's the one that reached out to me and said, hey, and she actually came out to Bend and visited me, and she's like, what can I do to help you do this, you know, on a bigger scale?
Oh, yeah.
So that's where this all got kind of started.
That's so cool. And just, you know, kind of one of those happenstance things where the Bend, Oregon store, like you said, became the last one. And then when it is the last one, it's like, okay, we can't close this. And then luckily it got enough publicity that it was able to continue to operate. So would you say you're pretty busy most of the time?
You know, it's kind of funny because this time of year is actually our slower time of year.
Okay.
We definitely pick up in the summer because people come to visit.
Of course.
Please do. Come visit.
Oh, yeah.
Visit the website. You know, just kind of help support. And if you have a local mom and pop, support them.
Yes.
Physical media is very important.
So it is very important. Agreed. Yeah, it's so fun too. You can pick up these movies here and not have to worry about late fees, right? You buy a movie and no late fees. But now, do you guys still do like cards and rentals and stuff just like normal?
Oh yeah, we operate exactly like normal. The only difference is we have merchandise here.
Right.
So everything is exactly the same. We still set up accounts every day. We still rent out movies every day. We still get new releases on Tuesdays. Everything's exactly what you remember.
I will say this, is our channel is Retro TV One Tech, so we're all about retro tech, but for me, you know, it's nice to have the physical media. You know, it's such a pain sometimes getting, oh, this movie was on Netflix, now it's not on Netflix, now it's not on this one or that one. You just have the thing in your hand and you push play and there you go.
Exactly.
There's something nice about that simplicity a little bit.
It is, 100%.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
Yeah, and thanks for thinking of us. Thanks for coming by and visiting.
Of course, thank you.
Yep.
Look, guys, it is a sports car videotape rewinder. Be kind. Rewind. And I love, this is actually a marquee and a sign from one of the original Blockbuster stores. So you can join today for a low annual fee. It just blows my mind that they still at the original block, or that the last Blockbuster there in Bend, that they still do memberships. They still do rentals the same way. And of course they do merch and things, diversification and all that. But it's just so cool. Oh, there's Elf playing and Fast and the Furious. And definitely check out the documentary on Netflix if you're interested in learning more about the Bend, Oregon store. And of course they have a website as well, which I'll link in the description. I remember True Lies too. What a great movie. And look how young, by the way, I showed this coming in, but look how young Arnold is in this movie. That's so cool. You know, it was the 90s. All right, we'll do one more lap around the store just to see if we missed anything. Here's Fox and the Hound. How cool is that? These classic Disney movies. I mean, you can tell they've been well loved, as it should be. $5 you can get one of these. I just, so cool. And Sword in the Stone. Look at that. And I mean, they've got multiple copies of each one. And a lot of them, you know, they're in really good shape considering, you know, what they've been through, and they've been well loved or been in somebody's closet or whatever. Here's Sound of Music. That one almost looks brand new. It's really cool. And The Secret Garden. Oh my goodness. Do you guys remember that one? What a great movie. Is this the one that I remember? Oh, that might not be the same one. I don't know. There was a couple of those made, I guess. So anyway, even Swiss Family Robinson. Like, come on, when's the last time you saw a Swiss Family Robinson VHS tape? It's just absolutely crazy. Yeah, I may have to get a couple of these. All right, so Mom and Dad and my son Liam, you guys are ready to make it a Blockbuster night, aren't you, buddy?
Yeah.
You get some movies, Liam? You ready to get the Transformers? Yes, $5. Very, very good price for those. And look at all the VHS on the rug there. That's a horror VHS rug. You've got Halloween and Friday the 13th and Dawn of the Dead and all these different things. Child's Play. Oh, my goodness. So funny. There we go. I got to join in, too, so I'm ready. I'm ready to watch some movies. Let's do this. We got our popcorn and everything. That's right.
We are a popcorn, buddy.
These are the old DVD cases here that you could get at Blockbuster. And, of course, they had VHS ones, too. They usually took them out of the original cases. So that's pretty cool though. Julie's Blockbuster franchise, North Fort Wilderness site 1644. Isn't that crazy? That's the Fort Wilderness campground site that they were on when they first did this in 2021. How cool is that?
Yep.
Very, very specific. So here's some of the vending machines and games that they would have had at some of the original Blockbusters. Here you can see this is like a pinball thing. Movie Blaster. That's fun. It's like movie pinball. Looks like it does actually work. Winner every time. You get like a little bouncy ball or something. And then Blockbuster, like sticker collection or something. Now this one doesn't look like it works, but you can even see the logo down there. So very classic, very cool. All right, so I'll do a last little walkthrough of some of the shelves and let me know if you see anything that stands out to you. I see Friday. I always love that movie, so much fun. White Castle, Harold and Kumar. It definitely, I'm going to go ahead and pick these up, Sword in the Stone and Swiss Family Robinson, because having those on VHS, that's pretty cool. Yeah, so they do have it kind of like separated out into different genres, comedy, action, all that kind of stuff. Like Martin Lawrence, Jeff Foxworthy, so fun. And then again, the family section is very nostalgic. Got Black Beauty there. That's actually still shrink-wrapped. Wow. Look at that. A lot of these are still shrink-wrapped, actually. That is really, really cool. And how cool, too, for these, you know, movies and DVDs that would have already maybe even been, you know, in the trash at some point. But now here, they've kind of got a new life, and people are interested, and people, you know, this stuff is coming back. Oh, here's like a Christmas section. Hadn't seen that. National Lampoon's, I do have that, or I would definitely pick that up. One of my favorite movies, National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, but I do already have that DVD. Deck the Halls, Jingle All the Way, The Santa Claus as a VHS. Wow, and that one looks like it's in great shape. It's not still shrink wrap, but it looks like it is in great shape. Borat, Ocean's 11, 12, and 13, all right in a row there. Yeah, so anyway, and again, if you come, you know, to this, there's no telling what kind of movies they'll have. Obviously it changes. People will, you know, buy these, and then people will you know, they'll restock and things. So you come here and you're gonna have probably a different selection and maybe some of the same, who knows. So fun. Night at the Museum. I don't know, my favorite still are the VHS's. So anyway, hopefully you guys got the full Blockbuster nostalgic experience here. It's a pretty surreal to be here and see all this, especially the VHS's. I mean, that brings me back to back in the day, going to even the mom and pop shops, like Sandy mentioned earlier, you know, just seeing the mom and pop shops that, you know, you're almost like a lot of those, if you guys remember from your hometown, like there, it was in somebody's house, you know, it was converted into a movie rental store. We had one called Broadway Video, and then there's one called Cole House Video, and they were in like somebody's house, basically. They'd been converted over. So yeah, there's Major League, by the way. We've got the sign that was over there behind us. So another copy of Pretty Woman on this side, Philadelphia. So a lot of different things. Great Expectations, Lord of the Rings. I don't know. Just so many classic movies, and definitely nostalgic to see the VHSs. There's Field of Dreams. So just to show you how big the sign is, there's Liam there, right in front of it. He's up to about the, just over the height of the letters there. It's a big sign. So it would have been outside of one of the stores. Pretty cool. All right, well, that was absolutely amazing. Such a nostalgic experience, reliving the whole idea of making it a Blockbuster night. All the incredible memorabilia in there, especially seeing the VHSs and all the incredible original Blockbuster items that are in there, from the counter, the drop box, the CRTs that are burned in. That, you know, fits right in with the channel here, you know, burned in CRTs. I guess they really were telling us the truth that if you left those on the same thing all day, they definitely would burn in. So really appreciative to everybody in the Blockbuster experience there for just talking to us and being so accommodating and everything else. It's truly worth it. Come out, $5, and you can relive making it a Blockbuster night right here at the Central Florida Fairgrounds. And go ahead and follow their Facebook and Instagram pages so you can see where they're going to be next. They said they're not sure exactly where. They're working on a couple other retro cons and 90s cons and stuff. So definitely check out their Facebook and Instagram pages. It's the Blockbuster Experience on Facebook and Instagram, and they'll keep you up to date on all of the latest happenings and news of where they're going to be next, because you know you want to check this out. And if you can't, go check out their website. You can get some merch and all that kind of stuff. And again, thank you to Sandy from the Last Blockbuster in the world at Bend, Oregon, for talking to us. Go check out that Netflix documentary. You can see more about her story there. It was just so cool to talk to her, you know, about the fact that they still do everything the same as they always have. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. We hope this brought back some great memories. Leave a comment about your favorite memories of making it a Blockbuster night. We'd love to read those in the comments down below. All right, everybody, that's all for now. So for now, enjoy that tech and keep it retro.